Still ahead here on our news at 4:30, we speak to a legal analyst about the deadly Minnesota shooting and the potential ramifications for that officer.
The deadly police shooting of Duante Wright in a suburb has a lot of frustrated people on edge right now.
Yeah, Wright was shot yesterday in Brooklyn Center, Minnesota, which is near Minneapolis. He was shot by an officer who police claim thought she was operating a taser instead of her gun. Joining us now is criminal attorney and legal analyst Thomas Glasgow. Thanks for joining us, Tom. Good to see you. So can you tell us about the legality of that traffic stop to begin with?
The legality of the police stop, if this were in the state of Illinois, they could stop for what they ended up saying was air freshener and an obstructed windshield. That stop would be presumptively legal. When they ended up stopping him and determining that he did have a warrant, could they proceed further? The answer would be yes. It's what happened after that which is uniquely troubling, considering everything that's been going on.
A lot of attention has been focused on the Derek Chauvin trial, of course, in Minneapolis, and then this happening not too far away from there. We heard from the police chief in Brooklyn Center, Chief Tim Gannon, who said it's his belief that the officer had the intention to deploy their taser here. But, I mean, accident or not, we're talking about a person getting shot and killed by a police officer here. What's the likelihood, Tom, that this becomes a murder case?
A murder requires a general intent to kill someone, whereas this, in the training and exercises that you end up having as an law enforcement officer, your weapon, your pistol, is always strapped to your dominant side. The taser, pursuant to the instructions and the training, is on your non-dominant side, and you're to yell taser, taser, taser before you end up actually using the taser on the person. In this situation, you heard that, taser, 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 but the person did not utilize the taser. They utilized their weapon, which probably, most likely, was an effect of a lack of training as opposed to an intent to actually kill the person. Now, that's something that has yet to be determined, but that's the most likely outcome based upon the facts that are available right now.
This is a very difficult case based on where it is. What really how things are in the country right now from a legal perspective. I know you kind of have to focus on your client. If you're representing this police officer, how do you move forward?
I'm deeply concerned that they're going to be charged with a manslaughter case because of the fact that they took substantial steps and did not use due care in the actions that they ended up taking. And they are, as police officers, allowed to use deadly force, but only under specific circumstances. And as we've seen with the change of force laws here in the state of Illinois, Minnesota has changed those use of force guidelines to include a step-by-step process that officers have to go through in order to implement deadly force, which probably was not done here if this were to be in accordance with Illinois law. Would that person be charged? Yes, I would be very deeply concerned that they would be. Would they be charged by the end of the day? Probably not. There's going to be a much deeper investigation. However, this is due in large part, in my opinion, to a lack of training in this area, where you can take steps to do things like use simulators, which has been used in the Skokie Police Department, and in my experience in the village of Arlington Heights, where we ended up putting in simulators into the police department there in order to de-escalate and practice de-escalation techniques, to end up using use of force techniques from the least restrictive to the most restrictive types of force, and then have a debriefing afterwards, and to end up utilizing that to talk to people that may have mental illness, PTSD, et cetera, in a scenario that's safe for the police officer, and giving them a teaching tool to end up coming back and not make these kind of mistakes in the street.
Yeah. Thomas Glasgow joining us to talk more about this shooting in Minnesota. Thank you so much. We appreciate talking to you today.
You're very welcome. Take care.